Soon after entering South Carolina, we come to Cheraw. The city is loaded with trees. They told me an old town law required anyone seen intoxicated on the street to go to the woods, bring back a tree, and plant it. This is the big, wide main street of Columbia, approaching the state capital. And here on the Capitol grounds, you have a chance to count real Southern bells. That stuff on the trees is Spanish moss. But the unadorned pine tree with its sticky, precious gum is an economic star. They harvest the gum and convert it into turpentine, rosin, and other products. US 1 crosses eastern Georgia for a distance of 226 miles. Just south of Waycross is Okefenokee Swamp Park. This place is beautiful, but it's got enough mystery to give even Chloe the creeps. They've got so many alligators here, they use them for pets. Yes, sirree. Somebody else, not me. Also, the kind of birds they keep in the zoo up north. Wise guy. We roll into Florida. 500 miles of sunshine, I hope. I have a nice stop in Jacksonville, which looks right pretty across the St. John's. St. Augustine is the oldest town in the U.S. They started cooking here in 1513. I hope your past is such that this view doesn't make you nervous. It's part of the old Castillo de San Marcos, which is now a national monument. At the Marine Studios, you can see the porpoises having a bite of lunch. Incidentally, what relative does this remind you of? At the sea zoo, you can meet a most affectionate little gal, a sea cow. These gentle sea creatures will nuzzle, but they won't bite. In fact, they're vegetarians. Florida grows 200 kinds of crops. This is a high-speed celery harvesting operation. Of course, the big deal in Florida is citrus. And this is where they squeeze and freeze the oranges like crazy. If you like beautiful scenery, how about moving to Palm Beach? Then again, maybe you like dog races. Ah, the dog. One of the rubber companies, I can't remember which, operates a blimp over Miami. So I buck up and go along for a ride. Then I head south on the Florida Freeway, island hopping for 135 miles, to our southernmost city, Key West, where you can see pelicans, sharks, and spectacular sunsets. Or a nice end of the line as arranged by the Kiwanians. Now there's just one more thing you want to know about this explorette. This is the end.